Speaking of, the two top candidates are taking steps to a court, a key voting block. They're trying to court women. 11 News reporter Kerry Cavanaugh is live in the newsroom tonight with more on what Governor Martin O'Malley and former Governor Bob Ehrlich are doing to win over female voters. Kerry?
Well, Bob Ehrlich unveiled a television ad that features all women, including his running mate Mary Kane. Analysts say it's a final push to appeal to a segment of voters who could help decide the race. Meanwhile, Governor Martin O'Malley is countering with an ad of his own that spotlights one of Maryland's most prominent female politicians.
College tuition at Maryland is going up.
My utilities are going up.
But O'Malley would raise our taxes even more.
Jobs are leaving our state.
Will my daughters find jobs here?
Frankly, in this economy, I have no more to give.
A series of women voiced concerns about Governor Martin O'Malley in the latest ad from challenger Bob Ehrlich.
Frankly, in this economy, I have no more to give.
Bob Ehrlich.
He won't tax us like we're rich.
He'll say no to things we can't afford.
Just like we do at home.
Political analyst Matthew Crenson believes Ehrlich, who is trailing O'Malley in the polls, is making a concerted push to get female voters to turn out on Election Day.
I would have expected them to try to bring out this appeal much earlier in the election. I don't know why they didn't.
Especially since Crenson says Republican candidates typically lose out to Democrats when it comes to female support.
More women are Democrats, and they respond to the appeals that Democratic candidates make. One of their concerns, for example, is education.
O'Malley is trying to make sure that theory holds true on November 2nd. He's appeared at a series of events called Thousand Women for O'Malley rallies, and on Tuesday, he'll roll out a televised endorsement from Maryland senior senator Barbara Mikulski.
Martin O'Malley's always been a hardworking, 24/7 kind of guy.
Crenson says the ad aims to depict O'Malley as a defender of jobs and education.
I've known him for 25 years. A lot of late-night chats, always about families, what they're going through, how to protect them.
We asked Professor Crenson if Mary Kane, Ehrlich's running mate, is likely to help him win over more women voters. She served as Secretary of State when Ehrlich was governor and appears at the end of the all-female ad.
The difficulty she's going to have in reaching out beyond the Republican base is that she's part of the Republican base. And I was a little surprised that Ehrlich chose her because she doesn't extend his appeal that much.
Now, former Governor Bob Ehrlich's campaign points out that he also has a vocal female base behind him in the form of a coalition called Women for Ehrlich. Meanwhile, Governor Martin O'Malley just scored two print endorsements from the Washington Post and the Easton Star Democrat. Reporting live in the newsroom, I'm Kerry Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.